हेलो एवरीवन, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर टॉपिक एंटी क्लाइन एंड सिंक्लाइन. ओके, बट लेट मी टेल यू दैट इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट सेवरल थिंग्स लाइक ग्लोब्स, मैप्स, इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ ग्लोब्स, इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ मैप, एलिमेंट्स ऑफ मैप, काइंड्स ऑफ मैप. सो दीज आर द थिंग विच यू हैव रीड इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास. इफ यू हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम ओवर देयर, देन यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट बॉक्स. ओके, आई विल जस्ट मेक अ न्यू वीडियो एंड जस्ट ट्राई टू resolve your problem. So today's topic is anticline and syncline. Let's go for this. So anticline and synclines are fold formed in the earth crust by the force of compression acting on the rock. So anticline and synclines, what are they? They are the folds. Folds means, as you can see, that there is a zigzag structure over there which is mostly present in the earth crust over some places. And it mainly occurs due to the force of compression, which you can see by denoting a arrow, the red mark, which you can see. This is the force of compression over there, through which it will become a anticline and syncline formation. Okay. So as the layer of rock get squeezed together, they get thrown upon in a series of fold. So as we can see, the layer of rocks are getting squeezed. Squeezed means like if we will just use some kind of sponge and just pour it in a water, thereafter if we will just remove it from the water and then we will squeeze it, will just let out some water from it. So if we will just squeeze together, they get thrown upon in a series of fold, means they will be get upon like a folding. Okay, they will just make a posture, or you can say make a position like a fold. When the layer of a rock bend upward in an arch, they form an anticline. Means when that layer, after compression, if the layer will fold and make a arch. What is arch? Like, as you can see, the arch is like this. Okay, so if it will make a upward arch, means the upward one. Okay, so that is called anticline. And when the lower, when the fold will bend downward, means downward side, means on the like horizontal. Okay, so it will just make a throw. Means it will also an arch, okay, which is being positioned in the downward side. So it will be called as syncline. Okay, so as you can see, there is a anticline and syncline over there in this diagram. The anticline, the upward arch is called anticline and the downward arch is called syncline. But the upward position is called arch. The bending on the upward side is called arch, and the bending in the downward side is called throw. Always remember that. Don't just use the same language in both of them, that the arch, upward arch and downward arch. No, it will be wrong. So you should use the upward position as arch and the downward position as throw. Okay, please remember that. Thereafter we will go for some vital words, and the chapter is, I think, over. Okay, so after that I'll just send you the question answer, true false, fill in the blanks, and you should write it down on your copy, and thereafter we will just start a new chapter. But before starting a new chapter, I want to give you a recap about this chapter. Okay, so let's go through this once. So in the beginning we have just learned about the globes and maps. What are globes? Globes is a three-dimensional model. Okay, we use globes to study the earth, and it is not very easy to carry around the world, so we use different kind of maps. Okay, what are maps? Maps are two-dimensional drawing which is very easily to carry from one place to another place, and that is why maps are very important, because of their simple visual format. We can easily read it, and mainly cartographer used to make map. Okay, and the geographical information system has make it very easily by image sent by the satellite, as you can see. Nowadays, we used to just make a map by using our satellite, okay? Thereafter, we will go for the kinds of map. Kinds of map means political map. Means this map will only show about the capital, important cities and the countries by a boundary, okay? And the physical map, as you can see, there is a no boundary of state and capital and all, okay? There is only the river, mountain, plains and plateau are being denoted, okay? So thereafter we will go for the thematic map. On the thematic map, we can see the distribution of crops, minerals and natural vegetations. Crop minerals, like you also know that rice, wheat, where do we grow some kind of rice, where do we grow some kind of wheat, where is the production of sugar cane is high. These are the details we will get from the thematic map. Thereafter we will go for the topographic map. Topographic map is the accurate and the best map, okay? It always tell you about the physical and cultural feature of that place with the settlement pattern, means where the people living, how many houses are there, where is the road going. I mean, like every single details is been noticed in this topographical map. Thereafter we will go for the elements of map, means in the map we use some sign and something to make it very simple for us to study the map. So these are the directions, scales, colors, symbol and legends, okay? Thereafter we had read about the directions. There are four kinds of direction: north, south, east and west, okay? And these are called cardinal points, and then now northeast, southeast, northwest, southwest, these are called intermediate point, okay? So thereafter we will go for the measuring distance. So as I have told you that the map scale is a ratio of the distance between the map and the original distance, or the original distance between two places on the ground, okay? How do we use to get the real measurement? Like if our map has a scale and it will show us that 1 centimeter equal to 1 kilometer, then in the map, if there is a gap of 1 centimeter between two places, means that is 1 kilometer away from each other, okay? Thereafter we have learned, we had learned about the scale has three ways, okay? So verbal scale, graphics or linear scale. Verbal scale, as I have just told you, that it will just show you that 1 centimeter represent 5 kilometer and all, okay? The graphics or linear scale, it will show in a horizontal line with a proper scaling in a map, okay? Like this, as you can see, this is the kind of scaling you will get on the map, and it is called what? Graphical scale. Thereafter we will go for the representative fraction, okay? You will get to just know that representative fraction because it is very important, and you can find the representative fraction by expressing the scale of the map in form of ratio. Like on the map you will get the ratio, and you will just have to use that ratio to get the map. If you will get the ratio like 1:25,000, means it will be written by 1:25,000 as expressed, okay? Thereafter we had learned about small scale and large scale map. So small scale map are drawn between 1 centimeter equal to 100 kilometer or more, okay? It will cover a large area, but as it is covering a large area, it will always have a less detail. And large scale map are always covering small areas, that's why they have a very large details, okay? They have the large area, as I have told you, okay? So the scale will be smaller, and the large scale map have the smaller area, that's why their scale is larger, okay? There are few things now you can understand about this, okay? Thereafter we will just come for conventional signs and symbol. So wait a minute. Convectional sign of convectional sign and symbols means there are some different kinds of symbols which we used by the cartographer around the world, okay, to read or study the map quickly and very easily. So that's called conventional sign and symbol. What is a key and legend? So as you can see, the key and legend is what? Key and legend is a symbol and sign used in the map. And why these are sign being uses? Means they will just denote you the exact description about that sign. Thereafter, sketch and plan. So as I had told you in the previous classes, that sketch is a rough drawing. It doesn't have any kind of scale and anything. It is just a rough drawing. Okay. Thereafter, we will go for a plan. So as we can see, plan is a detailed drawing of a smaller area like house, building or any working place or any street. Okay. So that is called a plan. But plan have a accurate scaling. Okay, and as you can see that the difference between the globes, map, sketch and plans. Okay, just figure it out, and if you have any problem in the between them, then you can just ask me in the comment box. I will just make a separate video for these differences. Okay, thereafter we will go for the diagram. Why we need diagram? What is diagram? So diagram is the thing which does just describe the working and structure of something. Like if there is a something like you can see that the Himalayas and the rivers are flowing, so we have to just show a diagram to just tell or just let them study about the flowing of river. So this is a diagram which is just telling us about the flowing of river, where if a river will start to flow, it have some like some points or some places where it being turned, and these are called something different. Like the source of the river, like Himalaya is the source of the river, it will the river start to flow from there. Okay, thereafter while flowing, the river will face some kind of curves and all, that will be called as meander. Thereafter, the tributary where the rivers will get separated. Thereafter, a distributary where the branch of the river will just separated by between two land. Okay, thereafter delta, where a small rock or land formed over the river. Okay, so these are the things. Thereafter, block mountain. As I have told you, block mountain is what? It is a divergent force on the earth crust. So from the earth crust there are some cracks or fault appear which just move up the rocks, and thus the block mountains were formed. Okay, let me show you the diagram. So here is a diagram of block mountain. As you can see that there is a upward crack and downward crack over there, and these are the divergent force which the black arrow, like bold black arrow, has been just telling us about the divergent force, and the small black arrow will just telling us about the force acting upon. And that's why the force is acting upward, means the earth crust will move on the upside and it will just form a block mountain. Okay, thereafter anticline, cycline, I had already told you, it is nothing but a fold which is just due to the force of compression which act on the rock. I mean, when the rock get squeezed together, it will just form a anticline and cycline. Okay, so after this I'm just sending you the question answer and all the exercises. Just read and learn it very carefully. Thank you.